So guys, in this video we'll be looking at the hello world shellcode. This is very similar to the hello world program which we have written in the previous video. Now just type this shell storm assembler in the Google and you will get this first string shellstorm.org and click on this link. Now what you can do is you can enter the assembly instructions and you can assemble into the opcode. Opcode is a hexadecimal representation of that instruction. On seeing, CPU executes this instruction and you can also disassemble. That means you can just paste the opcode and you can disassemble into the assembly instructions. Okay, now let's say move EAX comma 2, sorry, comma 2. Now you need to choose the which processor you need to emulate this assembly. Since we are dealing with x86 32-bit, now I am going to click on this and click this assemble button. Now you can see assembly in written Indian format is B8020002. So this B8 opcode is for move EAX and this is the value you are moving into the EAX. So this is when you write some instructions, this will be the opcode or you can call it a shellcode, but you can see that there is null byte. This is 0000. In the previous video we have seen that this null byte is a bad character for the string parsing applications. So we need to remove these null bytes, right? Now why, you can just ask yourself why this null byte is coming here. Means we are moving the 8-bit 2 value into the 32-bit register. That's why it's adding 3 bytes, I mean 24 bits of zeros and 8 bits of 2. So we can directly add AL comma 2. So what this means is we are moving 8-bit 2 into the 8-bit EAX register. That means accumulator lower. So when we assemble this one, you can see we have got only these 2 bytes and B0 and 02. B0 stands for, you can imagine, move into the AR, and this is the value you need to move into the AR register. So we have successfully removed the bad characters, I mean null bytes. That in this way you need to copy exactly the same bits into the register so that you don't get any extra bad characters. So guys, now we are going to write the hello world by this method to eliminate the null bytes. So I am going to create a new file called hello world shellcode.nasm. Now as usual I am writing the text global underscore start. Now I am defining a data section to store any variables. Now let's say message colon db define byte and the hello world. And I want to say another variable length. Dollar minus message gives the size of this message variable and I'm going to write the text section now. Up to now it's common, and now what we are going to do is we need to perform the write system call in order to print something to the output, right? To do that we need to store the 4 value into EX, which is the write system call. But now we change this to AR because this 4 can be represented in 8 bits easily and we are moving the only 8 bits. Okay. Now I am going to put some comments here because up to now I did not put the comments, and from now onwards you will see some socket programming concepts. So there will be lot of code here. And if you come back after a few months, then you may not understand that one. That's why I'm going to write the comments here. Now the first argument would be the file descriptor, which is 1. That means STD1 stands for the standard output. In the same way as the previous instruction, I'm going to say move BL comma 1. Now I am going to store the actual data you need to write into the CR register, which is message, and then finally DL into the length, because length we know that it's 12 or 13, I don't know exactly, so it can be easily fit in the 8 bits. Right, now I am going to say int 0x80. So this is our hello world program. Now we will also write a program for exit function. Okay guys, this is the code for the hello world, this is the code for exit. Now let me save this and let me assemble with NASM. Now our object file has been created. Now let's link that object file with LD. Okay, there may be some error. Okay, I think I have written everything correctly. So in text plus 5, relocation truncated to fit data. Text plus 5, okay. Let's see what it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one length. Now let's run our commands again. In function start, okay. Text plus 5. Okay, maybe the message, let's try CX. I think we have did everything correctly. Now let's once execute our, so there is no binary file. All right. Okay, I have understood now. What we are doing is we are passing the address of the message. That means it contains 4 bytes, that's why we need to put the ECX. Sorry for this mistake. I think now it should execute correctly. Okay, so sorry guys, I thought the message is just a number. No, that's an address. It consists of 32 bits. We need to copy into the full register ECX. So sorry for this. Okay, now our hardover shellcode has been printed. So let me copy all this. Let me copy this hello world one and let me paste it here. I think this assembler does not interpret these variables. So okay, let me delete this one. So instead of message, I want to say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So which takes 32 bit address. Now I think this one is correct one. Okay. So let's assemble one. So on assembly, we got this shellcode. Now if we execute in any application, we will get the hello world as an output. So in the next video, we will see how to extract the shellcode from that binary directory, and we will see a C program template to test our shellcode.